You know, I would like to talk, if I might, a little bit about the Speaker's bill that passed House Resources Committee, and it's the in-state gas pipeline bill, and I am opposed to it. There were two reasons given for promoting this bill. One is to get gas as quickly as possible to Alaskan consumers, and secondly, to get the cheapest gas possible to Alaskan consumers. And those are in conflict with each other. I mean, we know that. When you go for speed, you sacrifice, you pay more, and if you go for getting it lowest price, and it takes a little longer. So that's a first concern. More importantly, the proposal takes gas from the North Slope to the rail belt on what we believe is the wrong route. It bypasses Fairbanks, it bypasses North Pole, it bypasses the critical military bases, and price of energy is one of the things that is a consideration for military bases when they make their planning. It bypasses the vast mineral resource potential along the Richardson Highway. It has only two offtake points for the state. It has no economies of scale and potentially locks Alaskan consumers into high tariffs, high transportation costs for decades to come, and it offers no substantial new revenue to the state of Alaska. And all of this is aside from the fact that it sort of guts the Alaska Natural Gas Line Development Agency, which was put into place with a 62-64% vote of Alaskan citizens. I think it's the wrong project, and I think it's wrong-headed, and the only thing that puzzles me is why anybody does this. Oh, and the other thing about it is it brings gas from the North Slope to the rail belt, potentially undercutting development efforts in Cook Inlet. And we've focused a lot on trying to promote exploration and economic recovery of gas in Cook Inlet. So why would we then bring gas down from the North Slope to tell all of those explorers who have invested a lot of money that we're taking their market away from them, by the way? So I hope that bill dies a prompt natural death.